It's so nice.
I don't mind it, that vodka's
so
sweet, bro.
Smooth.
Smooth, mate. I don't even know you're drinking that, do you?
No.
Well, obviously not, we're drunk. You wouldn't have drunk as much as you did if you knew about it, that's for sure. As would you say, it's a little bit of a long process doing this, but it's worth it. It's worth taking a little bit of time to do it right. And look how nice and neat that looks with the clips coming through. Like I was saying, we could probably lose one if it's all the way through, but it just makes it so nice. Much a better job it doing nice. It this way.
And all the materials come for us, so it's nice to use them.
Yeah.
The more we use, the more we have to sell them.
And to be perfectly honest with you, these underfloor eating kits ain't that expensive for what they do.
They ain't, are they?
They're not expensive, mate.
How much is all this? How much is all this, Sam? 1,200 quid, was it?
£1,200?
Yeah, something like
that. Something like that. And we've
got a whole ground floor of house.
We've got 300 metres of cable, all the actuators, everything you need to install your underfloor eating.
Clips, down to the clips and the foam, around the edges.
Down to everything. Down the whole lot.
Because we're cheap on stuff, mate. Got some good deals at the moment on trade
really
deals.
Really good deals, yeah.
Some cracking deals. We've got some cheap material. Pop to Tommy's Yard. Just launched a new area called Trade Deals. And blinding off of
the more you buy, the cheaper it gets.
The more you buy, the cheaper it gets, yeah. Yeah. I think on one of them plumbing fittings, I think we're about a quid. We sell them in 25s, I believe, 50s and 100s a fitting. I think we're about a quid more if you bought 100 rather than 50. The more you buy, the cheaper it gets. We are cheaper, aren't we?
Yeah.
Where are we going now? Right all the way along?
Along, and then we're going to start running it through there.
Then come back on itself like that, yeah? Like, bit of a snake, yeah?
Yeah. Some people will give you, say, what you should do, you should come in a room and work yourself into a snail in the middle and work yourself out. But we're doing this at 150 centres. It's fly and return. As I explained in earlier, the system will heat up to 50 degrees, so you won't be getting cold spots. People will try and bamboozle you and say you're going to get cold spots here and there. You won't, because your system is set up to, if it's set up to heat to 50 degrees, it will keep heating up until it gets to 50 degrees. You ain't going to be getting cold spots on it. Don't let people confuse you like that. They're just trying to talk it up.
Use another 100 metres of pipe.
Yeah. This is the way to do it though, underfloor heating. If you've got a little area to do, bathroom, little kitchen, or a little utility room, you can use electric matting, that's good enough. You can have that. Have you had electric matting before,
Brad? Oh,
it's not bad for little areas.
It's alright, it ain't great though.
Not for a big area like this.
No way.
You couldn't do a big area like this.
I did my bath, something sound about it. My old house, I did my bathroom letting it. I had pebble tiles on top.
Yeah.
And they're quite thick.
Yeah. Didn't heat up enough.
It was warm, it took the chew out of it, but
yeah,
but that was all it did.
We're down 150. Just make sure we're not getting it.
What's on, brother?
The
reason you step it in 150 from the wall?
It's just you don't heat the wall up too much, really. If you've got a pipe, if you've got that pipe sitting right next to your wall here, what you're going to basically do, even with this foam, what you're going to do, you're going to try and transfer heat from your floor up your wall, which you don't want to be doing. That's why it's really important.
He took his shoe off.
I had a screw in my shoe and I couldn't obviously do it because I was filming.
Exactly. He got one boot on.
I didn't want to turn the camera off.
He's a boy, isn't he? Dedicated to his work, that is. That what you're dealing with in this cold weather is pipe.
That ain't the easiest, is it, to work with?
It hang on, it's freezing. Go on.
Got another one there.
Yeah. Once we, once obviously you get it laid and stuff, start getting some water run through it, it'll flatten itself out anyway. Put another one in here, pulled it out of the Sellotex. Again, it's just where the pipe is just so hard to work with at the minute. But if you've got come across a problem like this, it don't matter. We're putting these at 400 centres, but if you need to put them in a little bit closer together because you've got a dodgy bit of pipe, then don't worry about it, just crack another clip in. Alright, this is where
we've never got a problem, any solution.
This is where we've got to start running her down now, mate.
We'll come right across now.
We'll come right across.
That way, and then back out there, yeah?
Down now, up, down. Just get another cross clip. I'll stick another one on the bend here. Yep. Right, 150 from the walls, remember?
And 150 from the pipe itself.
Stick one in there as well. And then 150. This is your tricky bit when you're going around corners.
You're putting your boots on. You sausage, Sam.
Right, so we've got to pull ourselves back now.
That's the bit, isn't it? Getting that
That's the tight bit. That's the bit here.
We all make sure you don't do it, kink the pipe.
Oh, definitely, yeah, you can't be kinking that part. On these bends here, Sam, if you have a look what we've done, just try and stop ourselves kinking up. We've clipped it as you come round like that, and that's going to stop you kinking then, so you've got a nice swoop on there. Swoop.
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 Swoop, is it? Is that what it's called?
Swoop. Nice swoop. Sweep.
Sweep.
Sweat.
Sweat. Swoop. Yep. Nice swoop. Sam would be ordering this up and it's in flat.
Yeah.
Oh boys, that looks good. We had that. Yeah, boy, let me have that. Well, yeah, nice drop of granite and all.
Yeah.
Where was it there?
Yeah, it's I mean, once you've got your circuit worked out, it's just this for a couple of hours. Just running your pipe in, clipping it up, making sure you've got a flow return up to where your boiler is or wherever your manifold's going to be. You want your manifold as central to your circuits as you can, really.
Hold that a bit. Quite, it's when it twangs you in the face. And you're cold as well.
Pull that. Ah.
Is that right?
Oh. Monday morning.
Oh, it's more than 150, isn't it?
Yeah.
I don't get beers like that, I'm overweight. I can't get drunk at the wedding. She won't ever forgive me.
Watch it. I'm just going to try and untangle this a bit.
This is when you wish you'd cut it.
Yeah.
Start again.
Cut it, enjoy it.
Get a joiner on it. You're never going to get it perfectly straight lines. It's plastic pipe, it's a little bit wavy, it's not rigid copper. We've got today to get this floor down, pressure it up. Because you've got to leave it on under pressure time when you lay on the floor.
Well, yeah, once when it's being laid, you've got to leave it under pressure, yeah, just to make sure that it's not going to flow.
You're going to have 80 mil of concrete screed going on top of this.
Yeah.
So obviously, when that concrete screed's heating up,
it's going
to heat up. Pipes are going to heat up and they're going to expand. So you want to make sure you're full of water and you're pressured up to the hilt with it.
Yeah. 6 bar.
6 bar, yeah?
Yeah, you want it about 6 bar. You want to test this up for a day on about 6, and then a few hours on 4.
So what are we going to do? We're going to set up before we go today and leave this on pressure.
Yeah. Yeah, either that or tomorrow while we're here all day, because I've got two circuits to do.
Makes sense,
I mean, we're not going to, very unlikely you're going to get any leaks because we're not using no joiners, but you never know, factory fault. It's very unlikely with this stuff, but you never can be sure. You don't want to put your flow screen down and then find that you've got a leak under it. So yeah, it's quite important to test it up before it gets covered. Don't let too many people walk over it either, once you've done. Lace it down.
We're working in there tomorrow upstairs, doing all the plumbing again. We've got some insulation boards left over, Celotex, so we lay it on top of our walkway. But no one else is here, so...
No. Ideally, if there was other people here, you'd lay it today and then tomorrow morning, boom,
yeah,
have it covered.
Yeah,
no one's got the opportunity to walk on it.
How many clips in the box? 100?
I think it's 100. Sam?
Yeah, 100, yeah.
What did we get, 300 or 400?
Three.
Three?
100.
I thought we got four. Three.
Looks like we might be getting a few more.
I mean, look, we're putting these slightly leaner on this, good job. If you go any more with that, it's just going to start lifting up
quite a place. That's perfect, that is. Don't scrimp on them. I don't know what they cost, but don't scrimp on them.
Nah. I mean, you can see how difficult it is with putting them this close together. Can you imagine putting them at 500 or 600 apart?
And just with you, lift up. So that's coil, that's 150 metres on that coil, isn't it, Sam?
Yeah.
You've got two of them, so you've got 300 metres of pipe. So, I don't have to use that much, boy.
Probably not,
that. No. We'll use all them things, I'll remember, and then they'll cut them to crisps.
Yeah. That's the right old thing, mate. I think we will.
I'm getting to finish the same floor off tomorrow.
Aye.
Clips,
haven't
we?
Yeah.
Where's the cut from? We've got some in the shop.
Yeah? So it's our distribution centre.
Distribution centre, mate. We're getting bigger.
I feel like a cheese and onion sandwich.
You feel like you look like a roll.
Like a roll.
Yeah.
Crusty roll, burnt on top. You need to go to Littlehampton, mate, to get the bakers there.
There's a good bakers there, Wick Street.
That bakers is so
good. Wick Street, on the corner. Yeah. That's the best bakers.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where we need to go. We're not going to travel half hour for bakers.
Past McDonald's on the way, I'm going in there.
You can McDonald's.
I wanted McDonald's yesterday, I couldn't drive.
I had it, it was so good. Drive.
It's too dodgy.
I had a leftover Chinese.
It's sort of
far too risky for me to drive yesterday. Even in the afternoon, I wouldn't have been drunk still, but it was just.
It was
I
risky.
I couldn't function properly.
It was bad. It sort of me out though. Craving it.
Yeah,
you
can
have
another one
there.
So you've got one person
holding it. Definitely. You can imagine doing it by yourself.
Yeah.
What did the old thing you say you had to do it myself?
20 minutes. Matthew, our electrician, he's a nice chap, he's a nice geezer, but he talks on crap. Reckons you have all this. He reckons his mate can screed the whole ground floor in
40 metres, this is.
This is 40 square metres of screed, and he reckons his mate has screed it in an hour. Membrane and screed, cement screed in an hour.
A whole lot.
Go out, TV. He said it'd take him an hour and he'll have all his pipe work by himself. Do love geezers like that, don't you?
Yeah, we'll talk the job up.